Okay, we're back here at City Rib. I'm with Lathira. And Kelly and Robert. How are you? Good, good. So we're going to start here. Give us your name and your company and what it is that you do. Your name and your company.
My name is Lathira Forbes, and I am the founder and owner of Lathira Forbes Media Communications.
Nice. And how did you find out about the event?
I found out about this event through my mentor, Bill Andrews. And when I saw the name, the Black and Latina Council, I thought it was a great, you know, it sounded like a great event to attend to see if two cultures come together and actually ready to, like, you know, make a change in the community of business around with minorities.
Nice. And Kelly, how did you find out about the event?
Well, I'm always on Eventbrite looking for events, you know, for businesses and entrepreneurs involving minorities. And I happened to come across this event, and I said this was a good fit. And I'd love to go out and meet the different, you know, business owners, entrepreneurs, learn a little bit more about the organization.
And what's your business?
I am an exporter, international trader. I export goods to the Caribbean, and I'm looking to expand to South America and also Africa. So I saw this as a great opportunity, you know, to get my name out there and let people know what I do and, you know, speak to other people, find out what they do, and just absorb as much as I can.
Okay, this is a two-part question. What do you think you can do for the council, and what do you think the council can do for you?
Well, for one, with a background in accounting, when it comes to assets and liabilities, I feel that I'll be a great asset to add into the council, as well as they become an asset to me as I meet people, you know, throughout this organization that I can network with, because your network actually is part of your business. And then the more you network, you never know who you're going to find in the crowd to actually help you take you to that next level in business, or I may be that help to help them take them to the next level of business. We here to unite and just bring out the best in each other in business. So I feel like I could be an asset.
Nice. And how do you think the council can help you?
Oh, you're speaking to me. Oh, yeah. I'm sorry. I think that the council can help me pretty much touching on what Kira said, you know, by just networking, meeting different people, learning as much as I can, you know, getting my name out there. And also, I love the fact that, you know, it's a minority-based organization, and it's looking out for the communities and minorities in general. So I think that's very good.
Awesome. Where can we find you on the web? Hmm? Where can we find you on the internet?
On the internet, well, actually, LinkedIn. So you can find me LinkedIn. And I also have an email address right now. So.
Okay. And where can we find you?
At www.lfmc.co.
Nice. This is your card? Okay. Excellent. Beautiful. Can you pass that mic to Robert?
Yeah.
Robert, how are you?
Not bad, sir. Thank you.
Good, good, good. How did you find out about the event?
Well, actually, you wouldn't believe it. I was actually at work, and you know, someone here, the manager, actually called me over and told me, you know, how come I'm not over at the event here? So the office being right next door, and I decided to come over to say hello.
Well, we're glad you did. Now, I understand you're an architect, and you design the building.
Yeah, I mean, this is really fantastic. It's very good. You know, there's good unification, you know, like I think the two young ladies mentioned. You know, between African Americans and Latinos, I think it's a good drive, you know, in terms of business, you know, networking, you know, getting, you know, any type of, you know, even education going. I think it's a very, very good unification of this.
How do you think the Black and Latino Council can help you as a professional architect? How do you think the Black and Latino Council can help you as an architect?
Well, yeah, you know, that's very shit. What's happening right now, the drive, we find that we're getting a lot, which is very good, you know, Black and Latino ethnicity going within the architecture society. You know, I must say, you know, in terms of getting the licensing and moving on, you know, that number is increasing. You know, I could also let you know in terms of the ladies' role, particularly, you know, Latino ladies and Black women within architects, it's still very, very much a minority. You know, not using that word, but you know, it'd be very good if that those numbers could come up. And I think it would help greatly.
What advice would you give young people getting into architect?
Right now, I think, you know, like networking opportunities like this. In fact, when I walked in, there's a young man across the bar there who was asking me, you know what this was about. I told him, if you want to know, come with me, you know, get introduction. At least you'll be able to know who's out there, what people are doing. You know, this is a forum that you can get to do it. Not very often you get a good forum, you know, where you get, you know, people, professionals, and, for example, like yourself, let folks, you know, be able to let people know what you do. So.
And where can we find you on the internet?
Okay, on the internet, yeah, we're at rcga.com, rcga.net. We do, you know, a lot of aviation and airline development work. That's our main staple. But then we also do residential and, of course, restaurants.
Awesome. And Kelly, we can find you at LinkedIn, you said?
Yes, LinkedIn.
We can find you at LinkedIn. Yes. And we got your web address. Well, thank you very much for coming by. I wish you much success with the Latino Black Council. And thank you very much for stopping by.
Thank you for having us.
Thank you.
All right. There you have it. We'll be right back with some more interviews. Stay with us.